going?
Good. How about you?
Pretty good.
Nice. All right. So let's get this underway. We're going to ask some questions and you're going to answer them. It's going to be a good time.
Sounds good.
All right. So if you could be one Overwatch hero of your choice in real life, who would you be?
I think I have to go with my boy. You know, Lucio?
Oh, okay.
You can't say no. You know, I already have that bond with the character.
That's true.
Being able to run really fast or go off walls, it'd be like sort of like Spider-Man, except you just run across the walls instead.
You could also like sell out concerts in your free time.
That would be pretty good.
It's a pretty bomb DJ.
Yeah. And make some money.
Exactly. There you go. Do you have anything you do before your matches to hype yourself up?
Honestly, it's like one of my jobs to not be too hype. We have a lot of hype players on our team already. People get really excited. So I need to like keep us calm, make sure that we're thinking about what we have to do and thinking about what's going to happen. So I have to make sure that I'm not too hype, that I'm always thinking and make sure the other people on my team are thinking.
Boink, the calm man is what
I try. I try. It's a little hard sometimes, but...
That's fair. You do have some rowdy boys on your team.
That's true. Very true.
Can you give us some of your best tips for Lucio?
I would say just a lot of practice. It's a hero that's very different with mechanics. You run around on walls a lot. You have to make, like, it has one of the highest movements, and you have to move and aim, and I think a lot of characters don't have that as much. So I would say a lot of practice on that. I generally do, like, FFA games and just play Lucio in it because I think, like, that's the best way to practice your mechanics. You practice mechanics more so in that than you do in like a game of ranked. Because you just respawn instantly and you go and fight somebody again. And it just repeat, repeat, repeat. Whereas if you're playing properly in ranked, which I don't always do sometimes, so don't tell anybody. But if you're playing properly, don't run into those situations a lot. So you need to be prepared. Like you need to prepare yourself in other ways other than just ranked in order to be ready if those situations pop up.
Smart. What was your favorite part of the homestand, and what elements are you excited to see when you get to your own home games?
I like the fans a lot. Yeah. Honestly, the fans were crazy. You would think being in Dallas that we wouldn't have as many fans. I mean, we're still in Texas, right?
Right, yeah.
But I swear the crowd was 50-50 maybe. Like, we had so many fans out there. So it was really great to see all of them, get all the support. The game was super close. It was super exciting. And it was just... Even though we ended up losing that, I think it was still a really good showing overall, and it was a lot of fun. And meeting all the fans afterwards, too, it's definitely the most enjoyable part, is you get to see everyone who actually shows you support and shows up there, and it's crazy.
Also barbecue, right?
Oh, yeah, we went to barbecue.
Yeah,
don't worry.
Barbecue is
also
the important part. Yeah.
Exactly.
This is one that I've been wondering as well. How did you get the name Boink?
Okay, well, I played a lot of games when I was a kid. So I kept picking names randomly here and there. Like, I know one of my first names was like Dan the Man. You know, the classic, every time you're named Dan, every person has Dan the Man, 100%.
At least once. I still know a Dan the Man.
See?
Yeah,
exactly.
You're right,
exactly.
Yeah.
So I played MMOs a little bit, and then I played Team Fortress 2. And I didn't really have a non-MMO name, and I was like in seventh grade or something. So one of the characters said Boink, and I was like, okay, I want to make that my name. And then I took it from seventh grade. I never changed it, and then I just sort of stuck.
I love origin stories. They're always my favorite. What is slash was your favorite moment from your time in Overwatch League?
Ooh. I don't know. There's so many good moments, honestly. We played 40 games last season. We've played a lot this season. Like, there's so many good moments. I would just say, like, any good victory, like the London one, any of the London ones stick, like, come to mind. I think they're a really good team. They were really good last stage. I mean, they won last season, right?
They did. Yes, true.
So we went 4-0 against them in the regular season. So I think that was, like, any win from there. There was a couple of reverse sweeps we did. I remember the reverse sweep versus Florida that we did. That was, like, crazy. So I don't know. I just one of those moments, I guess.
Good vibes.
Yeah,
good
exactly.
Vibes all
exactly.
Yeah. What is your favorite map to play Lucio on?
Ooh. This one's tough because it depends on the meta. But I think Ilios is always like a standard Lucio map. It's always really fun. There's boops off the edge on one map. There's a giant pit and edge on the map for that one.
As Monty calls it, the murder hole.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. So... yeah, there's an edge on the third map. I feel like that's like one of the most exciting maps to play Lucio on because you always have an opportunity to do something. And that makes it a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who is the most difficult player to play against in a match?
Honestly, I would go with either happy as he destroyed us today on DPS.
Scary.
Yeah, top moment for sure. Carpe also comes to mind when he's playing DPS on Widow. Any of like the insane good Widow players are so hard to play against because you can only have a strategy that encompasses so much. When the guy just hits every shot or just grapples in and kills the one player you need, it's... you really can't do much about it. Like, if he hits his shots, it's really hard to play against. So I'd say any of, like, the top Widowmakers, especially Happy and Carpe.
Yeah, especially it's like if you breathe outside of spawn and you're dead.
Yeah, that's, exactly. That's exactly. You want, like, your Reinhardt drops his shield for, like, a split second, you die, and it's like, you feel so bad about it, but you couldn't do anything. You just found the little window which he gets it. So
it's just going in slow motion, and it's too slow to stop it, and you're like, no!
Exactly. You see it happening, and then suddenly it's just too late.
Oh, so sad.
You see the grapple up in the air, then...
and then you know.
You just stare at him, you make eye contact, and you're like, I'm dead here. I know it.
You know it's coming.
As soon as you look at him, that's why you have to turn around and hope. You just don't look, and you won't get hit. They're not there if you don't see them.
They need a new emote for support players that's just tying a blindfold because you know a Widow is coming for you.
Exactly, exactly.
What was the hardest change for you to make when you moved to LA?
I would say living alone, I think, is like, well, it's I had a roommate for the first year, but it's a little different than living with your parents, I would say. Yes, I lived alone during college, but... it's like, I moved, or I was college, and then I moved home for like a year and a half or 2 years, and then I got used to that. I also moved away from my pets. I'd say that's like a big one, is I have a really old cat. He's 14 and a half or 15. Oh, wow. So, and he's terrible in car rides. Like, he, we would try and take him to the vet when he was younger, and he could not go to the vet both ways without... doing something in the car. I don't want to say it on screen, but so anyway, that was probably the biggest thing, is moving away from pets and stuff like that.
Get boink a cat. Get
or
boink
dog.
A cat.
I've been thinking about a dog.
Get boink a dog. 2K19. I like this campaign. All right, last question. Boink, what is your favorite food? And then may I make it for you? I feel like I need to point out, this is from Big Chef Gaming, so this sounds like somebody who's prepared to make you your favorite meal.
Okay, interesting. I didn't see the name. That's actually important.
Yeah.
That means that they're committed, you know? You don't pick that name without actually being able to back it up, you know?
Big Chef Gaming wants to know, what can they make you?
I really like shrimp scampi.
Ooh, good choice.
Shrimp scampi is really good.
Yeah.
I'm just a big fan of pasta in general.
Ooh, double good
So anything pasta, and I like seafood a lot, so shrimp scampi kind of like hits the little mid-ground between the two, so that's probably like one of my favorite dishes.
All right, Big Chef Gaming. That's your challenge.
You may make it for me, by the way.
There you go.
I just want to make sure it's a given, you know?
Well, thank you so much, Boink, for joining us. And thank you, Twitch All Access Pass holders, for coming to this Q&A. Remember, there's more.